Do you know any keywords useful for eBay clothing sellers? I'll tell you mine in this video. Hello ladies and gents, and welcome to the channel. If you're new here, I'm Polish Pete and I sell cheap ladies clothing on eBay UK. This is how I make my living, and today I would like to talk about keywords that I use to sell my stock. Now, a little disclaimer here, I'm not a keyword expert. On the contrary, guys, I'm a blog and I'm an immigrant. English is not my first language, and as a blog selling ladies clothing, well, sometimes I feel like a child in the woods. Words like, you know, rockabilly is just like a black magic for me, you know. Knowing if something looks like 30s, 50s, 60s or 70s is just beyond my ability to understand, honestly. So I don't create great titles. There is still a lot of learning for me. So guys, let's treat this video as a starting point. If you have some good keywords and you know how to explain them to me and to other viewers, please leave the comment down below and share your knowledge. So let's start. So guys, before I jump to the specific keywords that I use, I would like to talk about one thing. And in my opinion, even seasoned sellers often miss that. You know, keywords is not only your title. Yes, the title is the most important, but the title has a limited space, so we have to use other places to stick our keywords in. The beginning of the description. In this place, I usually repeat my title and I stick all the secondary keywords that I didn't manage to fit into the title. Another place to put your keywords in is your item specifics, with the theme item specific being the one that I use the most. If you can't choose the keywords on the list because it's not there, just type it in. It still counts. Algorithm will find it and will use it, and your item will pop up in the search results due to this keyword. Okay, enough faffing around. Let's go to first keyword. The first keyword that I had great success with is workwear. Yeah, from the moment I started to use it, I have noticed a lot of this kind of item selling. You know what I mean by saying workwear. If you don't, just close your eyes and imagine yourself a lady working in the office. Yeah, white tops, dark bottoms, stuff like that. Also, together with workwear, I often use classic, which is kind of very, very close keyword to that workwear. If I still have a space in the title, I put office in the title. If I don't have a space, I put it into item specifics. Often with this kind of items, there is some sort of the collar. So if the item has a collar, I always put collared or collar if I'm short of space. Also, a good keyword that is kind of the same family is interview or job interview. I had a bit of success with this kind of keywords. Now, the second keyword that I use the most is floral. This was something that I have noticed when I came to live in this country. Floral patterns. Honestly, within first week of my stay in England, I must have seen more floral patterns than within 30 years of living in Poland. Honestly, anything floral in this country is pretty much guaranteed sale. It's just a matter of price and time. So if there is a floral pattern on your item, don't forget to mention that in your title. I also put word flower into theme specifics, and obviously floral into patterns, item specifics. In this case, I like to use summer and spring words as well. And if we talk about patterns, if those flowers are little tiny flowers on the item, I use also spotted, as a kind of like a spotted dress, because those flowers are just tiny and looks like it's spotted. Okay, next useful keyword that I would like to mention is vintage. If you have a vintage item, don't forget to put that in your title. I also put that into theme, and there is a special item specifics that says vintage, and you can choose yes or no. So if item is not vintage, this don't have a much of importance, but if item is vintage, be sure that you mark it accordingly, choosing yes in that vintage keyword, in that vintage item specifics. Together with vintage, I like to use a word retro. I know it's not the same, but to me it doesn't make a difference. I can't distinguish between vintage and retro, so I put it in anyway. Now, any kind of fastening can bring some good results. So try to put at least into the item specifics what kind of fastening the item has. For example, buttons, drawstring, zip, belt, or something, keyhole, or something like that. I think there is no point to, explain that, in more details. The next word, speaking about details, the next word is detail. If an item has any like a meaningful detail, I use word detail with conjunction with, for example, floral detail or lace detail or something like that. Another similar word to that is motif. Yes, so floral motif or something in this kind. Another good word is sheer. So if the item is kind of see-through, and the word you can use is sheer, and I also use it with conjunction with other words saying, like say sheer shoulders or sheer sleeves, etc. Yeah. Similarly, if item is kind of lacy, I use terms like lace shoulders or something in this kind. If the item has a metallized fiber, you can use words like glitter, sparkling, sparkly, or even metallized fiber itself. Also, with that kind of items that are lacy, sparkly, etc., I like to use words like party, night out, evening, and this kind of words. Talking about evening, if you have a dress that is kind of evening dress, you can use keywords like club, clubbing, cruise, occasions, or even wedding or wedding guest, depending on what actually item is. Another word that I had a lot of success in the past is nautical, yeah, which can be applied to horizontally striped tops, mostly black and white or navy and white or blue and white. This kind of colors, yeah. And I really had a lot of success with that keyword, especially about a year ago, a year and a half ago. A bit less now, but still, it still works. If the item is obviously summery, like a sleeveless top or very lightweight something or strappy top, things like that, I like to use words like summer, summertime, holiday, beach, and travel. Obviously, not only in the title, but mostly in the item specifics. Now, there is one more word that I had a lot of success with, but some people may say that it is inappropriate to use this kind of keywords. I think it's not. I think you should really use it, because if you like to give your customers what they are looking for, and they are looking for that keyword, there is no point not to include that keyword if the items falls into that category. And whenever I used that keyword, the item was selling quite fast. So I used this keyword for kind of like black trousers, black long skirts, black jumpers, black tops, and items with no details or decorations on them, like plain items. And the word is funeral. And yes, I know. That's why I've said that not everybody will find that appropriate. But you have to decide for yourself. I can only say that I have always sold those kind of items quickly. So it means that people are looking for it. Yeah, and that's about it, guys. That's about all the keywords that I really use. At least keywords that I use on a regular basis. I don't have many interesting keywords really in my eBay dictionary because, like I've said, I'm a blog and I'm an immigrant. So if you have some interesting keywords, please leave them down below and try to explain, what kind of items you use them with. Please share your knowledge, guys, not only with me, but also with other viewers. And we will be all, learning something new out of this. So please contribute if you can and leave some comments. Thank you for today. Please like the video if you find that informative or helpful. Consider subscribing to the channel if you haven't done so yet. And for today, thank you very much for watching. God bless you all and bye bye.